In the free version of WooCommerce, the shipping screen, located under the WooCommerce Settings Shipping tab, supports 5 core shipping options that are listed across the top of the shipping screen. Flat rate shipping, free shipping, international delivery, local delivery, and local pickup. Flat rate shipping is used to bundle items together for shipping at a set price. It can be a shipping price per item, or it can be a shipping price per order. To enable this option, check the Enable/Disable button. Remember to click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen to save any changes. On the flat rate shipping screen, you can set the name that a customer sees when using this option by entering a name in the Method Title field. You can restrict the countries where this shipping option is available by selecting from the Availability drop-down menu. If you select specific countries, then you'll need to specify which countries you want selected. This will override the default countries set under the General tab and allow the shipping option to only these selected countries. On the other hand, selecting all allowed countries will allow the shipping option to all the countries selected under the General tab. The tax status selection is available for countries that add tax to shipping, like Australia, for instance. The cost per order adds the amount entered in this field to the entire order. Set this for a minimum or base shipping amount. Additional fees can be added to this amount by using the options below. Additional rates is a section used to offer alternatives to the shipping cost per order amount. Additional rates has 3 parts: a name, a cost amount — this is a number or a percentage or a combination of number and percent — and a control option, and it follows a specific format. The name followed by a space, a pipe followed by a space. The pipe key is usually located on the right of the keyboard with a backslash. It looks similar to the colon. Hold the shift key down and press the key. The cost followed by a space, another pipe followed by a space, and finally the control option. The option name used is what the customer sees as a title for this option. The cost amount is entered here, and this amount will be added to the cost per order entered above. And the control option allows you to specify either order, item, or class. Order adds the amount want to the entire order, while item adds the amount for each item in the cart. And shipping class, which is a way to group similar products together for shipping. Shipping class is controlled in the additional cost section below. Additional rates can get quite sophisticated when used to combine rates and percentages with the various options, but use with caution. It can also be very confusing to a customer if there are too many choices and variations in shipping. Additional cost has 3 parts, and these costs are added to the cost per order and additional rates. Cost added controls how the costs below are calculated. You can select it to be added once to the entire order, for each item in the cart, or for the shipping class, which is set below. Shipping classes are added by navigating to the Products Admin screen and clicking Shipping Classes. These classes have the same format as categories and work in much the same way. Classes are added by entering a name, and they can even be a subclass of another class. These shipping classes are added to each individual product when creating a product. You can also edit a product and add that product to a class. For instance, if I add a class named Oversize for items that are large and bulky and that require additional shipping fees, I can then add products to that class by editing the product. Under the Product Data Shipping panel, I can add a class. To add the additional costs associated with the shipping class, navigate back to the flat rate shipping screen. Locate Cost for Shipping class and click the Add Cost button. Select the shipping class and add the cost and a handling fee if needed. Click the Save Changes button at the bottom of the screen to save any changes. Now, when this item is added to the cart, the additional shipping cost will be calculated. This cost is separate from the cost per order and the additional rates, making it possible to control shipping with shipping classes only. And the shipping class fee will also be added to any additional rates entered. And a word of caution, any shipping class that does not have a cost should be removed from this list. Leaving an empty shipping class in this list have been known to cause problems when calculating shipping. The minimum handling fee is used to ensure that there's a minimum fee charged. This fee is checked against the shipping class handling fee selection above and is applied according to the selection for cost added. So if you set a cost per item, then the handling fee, or the minimum handling fee, will apply to each item, whichever is greater. The minimum handling fee is handy when using percentages for shipping. This helps ensure that you receive at least the minimum amount. Remember to click the Save Changes button to save any changes. The flat rate shipping options have a lot of different possibilities. These rates should be tested thoroughly before applying them to a live site.